And how's it going, guys? It's Josh Olufemii.
Hey, what's up, guys? I'm Chris Simon.
Guys, Chris Simon is one of my best friends, and he's a producer, a creator, video editor, does everything. He owns a production company called Darebloc. They've been basically producing all my music videos. They're getting a YouTube channel.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Dope. Link is going to be below. You guys should check it out. More to come from Chris. It's going to be awesome. But this video is specifically going to be about a wise way to shoot music videos. So we're going to be specifically breaking down the work of one of my favorite directors and good friends, Clarence Peters, based out of Lagos, Nigeria. Clarence is often the director of choice of one of my favorite record labels, Mavin Records, led by the legendary record producer and artist himself, Don Jazzy. For a lot of you guys, these names require no introduction, but these guys have basically defined the sound and the visuals of West African entertainment for quite a while now.
I'ma follow me, college. She said she wants to follow me. See, I did it, got out me, oh, Lily. She wants to call out me, oh, buy you anything cool.
Now, before we get started, there's technically no real right way to make a music video. You know, it's all about the artist's vision, it's all about the vibe that you want to create. However, there is a base rubric that you can use to structure your music video and tweak it as needed.
A song is usually broken up into an intro. This is basically the instrumental bar at the beginning of the song before you actually start hearing the lyrics. Then there's verse one, then there's chorus one, and then there's verse two, and then there's chorus two. Then maybe there's a bridge to break things up, and then there's verse three, and then chorus three. And then there are these things called pre-choruses, but we're not gonna even really tackle that in this video. So have you ever watched a music video and you just kinda got bored because you felt like you were kinda looking at the same footage over and over again? This is something that a lot of us deal with in our kinda amateur, you know, stage of film production where we spend all day shooting, and then at the end of the day, we're editing, and we realize, dang, we really actually don't have a lot of types of footage to play around with. So this is what we do. We're gonna break up the amount of footage that we need to shoot into six types of footage. So there are six types of footage per verse chorus segment that I usually like to write into all my treatments.
First, there's primary performance. This consists of your artist performing at the main location. This really kind of anchors the rest of your footage for the rest of the video.
Then there's the primary performance B-roll. This is basically the same thing as your primary performance footage. The artist is literally in the same location, but they're not singing any lyrics. Maybe they're just posing, moving their arms, closing their eyes. And this is usually always shot at a high frame rate so you can slow stuff down into slow motion. An easy way to capture your primary performance B-roll is to actually capture it during the last take of your primary performance shots. You just gotta tell your artist not to speak or sing, but to just pose and move during those choruses of that last take. Now, why would you do this? Because at this point, you probably won't need any additional footage of choruses being sung, because choruses, unlike verses, are completely identical regardless of the take that you're doing, regardless of the verse that they're next to. By the way, that's a trick from Matt Alonzo. Shout out to Matt.
Then there's the primary narrative B-roll. This footage usually avoids the lyrics being mouthed, but it really tells the story of the music video. You know, small things like a guy entering a party, showing the beer pong table where, you know, people are playing, showing a girl notice a guy and go after to go flirt with him. The little things that really forward the narrative of your music video. This would also include any aerial shots that establish the scene in the song intro. And again, shoot this in a high frame rate, so that way you can slow it down and make it look really cinematic.
Okay, so now we're gonna move into the secondary performance shots. These are just basically performance shots shot at a secondary location. They just give you something different to get to within any verse chorus segment that you're in. The secondary location usually matches similar theming to the primary location, but it still has a lot of attributes that are distinctly different. So in the Crayon So Fine video, video directed by Clarence Peters, you can see that the primary location that they used for the primary performance shots was actually him standing on the balcony singing down to the girl. And the secondary performance shots were actually actually on the stairs. You could see that the secondary location was similar to the primary location, but it was distinctly different. You could see the same railing in both shots. And it's also in that secondary performance footage that a smart director is going to make sure to capture any specific ad-libs that an artist may sing in the song.
And really good directors will do this quick, maybe they'll even keep the camera rolling, and that will save your day, it will save your budget, and will make sure that you get everything you need when you move into post.
And guys, secondary performance B-roll is exactly the same thing as secondary performance shots, except there's no lyrics being sung. The artist is literally in the same location, but just kind of moving, vibing, you know, doing anything but actually singing the lyrics.
Now let's talk about cutaway B-roll shots. Now, these are shots that don't really have any true significance to the narrative of the story, but it's definitely gonna add to the vibe of the video. You know, these are close-up shots of body parts, jewelry, clothing, brands, ambiance, anything that you can use in quick succession to really just add that visual complexity to make your project look special.
And of course, all these six different types of music video footage will be broken up into their individual wide shot, medium shot, close-up shot differentiations. So guys, the main reason that you're making sure that you're capturing every one of these six types of music video shots is to avoid something that I like to call attention fatigue. It's basically a feeling that your viewer will have where it feels like things are being drawn out longer than expected.
Like, you ever watch a music video where it seems like the editor is cutting between the same footage all day? It gets really boring. You need to make sure that you have really unique visuals for each chorus, each verse, and that unique visual complexity, like I said earlier, is really gonna separate that amateur feeling music video from something that's truly professional. Just make sure that you have unifying themes between each type of your content to make the whole video feel cohesive.
Now guys, before the keyboard warriors start typing, know that not every music video is going to include all six types of footage that we've talked about. More performance-based video may not include a lot of the primary narrative B-roll footage, and maybe just focus on the remaining five. More narrative music videos may exclude a lot of the primary and secondary narrative B-roll footage and just focus on the remaining four. Heck, there are some music videos that are all just primary B-roll footage without any performance footage at all. I suggest, however, that all rules and traditions are meant to be broken at some point, as long as they're broken intentionally. Knowing these six types of footage, however, will give you the foundational structure that will be able to allow you to reverse engineer not only your work, but other people's work, and from that, develop your own visual style.
You know, your own unique visual style is so important because that's how you're gonna brand yourself as an incredible director, as an incredible editor. So after a while, you know, artists are gonna come to you for those special things that only you can create.
I'd like to shout out Clarence Peters and his entire production team for being such an inspiration to us all. And I want to shout out Don Jazzy and the entire Mavin team for basically creating culture for so many years. Now guys, in the last week, I've probably spent close to 12 hours downloading tons of random stuff from Envato Elements. I've used a ton of their aerial stock footage to use as my primary narrative B-roll in my last music video. I tried like four title packs before settling on just one for my main title sequence. I've checked out so many different sound effects options from their sound library and their music library just to accent specific scenes. And that's just the tip of the iceberg. You can basically download any title packs, VFX packs, sound effects packs, stock footage, anything you can think of, music, for only $33 a month. And through Olufemii Tutorials, you can get the first month for only $9. And the best part is you can cancel at literally any point without any weird cancellation fees. Guys, every subscription helps the channel out, so please check it out and tell me what you think. You guys are the best. Please make sure to click the like button, the notification bell, the subscribe button. Thanks so much for watching. And as always, remember to keep it chill.
We got a really good looking show.